Hello, I'm Maruk Said, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Double-stranded DNA virus known as Human Herpesvirus 6, or HHV-6, is a member of the genus Roseola virus of the Herpesviridae family, subfamily Beta Herpesvirini. Exanthema subitum, also referred to as sixth disease or Roseola infantum, is a common pediatric illness that is caused by HHV-6 primary infection, a spherical protein shell with 20 equilateral triangle faces, known as an icosahedral capsid, envelops the double-stranded linear DNA virus that is known as human herpes virus 6. The tegument, a protein coat that covers the capsid, is followed by the envelope, a lipid membrane that the virus absorbs from the host cell's nuclear membrane and contains viral glycoproteins. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. HHV-6 infection now starts when an individual comes into touch with respiratory secretions from a virus-carrying individual. Once within the body, the virus binds to antigen-presenting dendritic cells, which are abundant in the lungs, stomach, intestines, nose, and skin. These cells are able to process antigens like viral proteins and present them on the cell surface to the T cells. Thus, the virus activates dendritic cells upon attachment, causing them to move to lymph nodes and engage in interactions with CD4+ T lymphocytes. T cells absorb the virus when they connect with dendritic cells, which causes them to become infected. The virus can reproduce most effectively inside T cells, where it goes through the lytic cycle, in which its DNA is translated and transcribed by cellular enzymes to make viral proteins. These proteins are then packaged into new viruses that may infect nearby cells after the original cell is killed. Though not as effectively as within T cells, the virus may also replicate into a wide range of other cells, including astrocytes, macrophages, natural killer cells, glial cells, monocytes, and megakaryocytes. Lastly, HHV-6 has the ability to enter a latent state in monocytes, where it simply resides inside the cell rather than causing any harm. This may sound harmless, but in people with immunosuppression, especially after a bone marrow or organ transplant, the virus can reactivate and cause serious infections, such as encephalitis. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. However, the majority of the time, HHV-6 causes Roseola infantum, a disease that often affects young infants between the ages of 6 months and 2 years. The illness takes 1 to 2 weeks to fully develop. Following the incubation phase, the illness often manifests as a high fever lasting 3 to 5 days, with a temperature that can reach above 40 degrees Celsius or 104 degrees Fahrenheit. Acute otitis media, rhinorrhea or runny nose, cough, vomiting, diarrhea, a protruding fontanelle, cervical, occipital, or postauricular lymphadenopathy, and Nagayama spots, which are tiny red spots on the soft palate and uvula, are some other symptoms that may occur during the feverish phase. Once the fever has subsided, pink or red dots called maculopapular rash appear. Initially affecting the neck and trunk, they later extend to the face and limbs. The rash often goes away in 1 to 2 days, although occasionally it might disappear in as short as 2 to 4 hours. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Clinical features are typically the basis for the diagnosis of Roseola: an increase in IgG antibodies against HHV-6, as well as the virus's cultivation and PCR identification of viral DNA from clinical samples like blood, cerebrospinal fluid, or respiratory secretions, can all be used to prove the existence of HHV-6. Treatment for Roseola is mainly supportive because the condition tends to heal on its own. Antipyretics like acetaminophen or ibuprofen can be used to treat fevers, and increasing fluid intake can help avoid dehydration in the event of vomiting or diarrhea. The rash disappears on its own. In extreme situations, such as HHV-6 infection in immunocompromised patients, antivirals such as ganciclovir or acyclovir can be used. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Summary. Okay, to quickly review, double-stranded DNA virus known as Human Herpesvirus 6 replicates most well in CD4+ T cells. It results in a condition known as Roseola Infantum in young infants, which is marked by a high fever that lasts for 3 to 5 days and a rash that occurs after the fever goes down. The clinical presentation is often used to make the diagnosis, and supportive care is the standard of care. However, in instances that are severe, antivirals such ganciclovir or acyclovir may be used.